गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट बोन इज हाईली कैल्सिफाइड। बोन इज हाईली कैल्सिफाइड और मिनरलाइज्ड। बोन इज अ हाईली कैल्सिफाइड और मिनरलाइज्ड सॉलिड हार्ड एंड रिजिड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू। इट इज द मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द एंडोस्केलेटन ऑफ अडल्ट वर्टिब्रेट्स। बोन इज द मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द एंडोस्केलेटन ऑफ द अडल्ट वर्टिब्रेट्स। इट इज मेनली प्रोवाइड स्ट्रक्चरल फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ द बॉडी। इट प्रोवाइड्स मेन स्ट्रक्चरल फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ द बॉडी। Next, it supports organs and protect internal organs or delicate organs. Limbs of long bones serves weight bearing functions. Limbs of long bones are legs or hands. Limbs of long bones serves the weight bearing functions. Next, bones helps for the attachment of muscles for the movement of the body. Bone acts as homeostatic reservoir for calcium, magnesium, phosphorus. Bone is a homeostatic reservoir for calcium, magnesium and phosphorus. Bone maintains calcium, phosphorus and magnesium concentrations. Next, bone is highly vascular. Cartilage is avascular. Bone is highly vascular. Bone acts as hemopoietic organ. Hemopoietic means blood cells formation. Heme means blood cells. Poiesis means origin, production. Blood cells in long bones. Some long bones of bone marrow forms blood cells. So bone acts as hemopoietic organ. Hemopoietic organ. Bone has three parts: matrix, cells, and a bone marrow. Bone includes three parts: matrix, cells, and a bone marrow. Matrix is non-living substance. It is hard and non-pliable. Cartilage is pliable and flexible. Matrix in bone is hard and non-flexible. Matrix has rich calcium salts and collagen fibers. They give strength of bone. Bone cells. Bone has three types of cells. Osteoclast, osteocyte. Bone has three types of cells. These are osteoblast, osteoclast, osteocyte. Osteoblast cells are Osteoblast cells also called mineralizing cells of bone. These form fibers of bone. Osteoblasts are immature cells. Next, osteoclast. Osteoclast cells are demineralizing cells. Osteoblast are mineralizing cells. Osteoclast are demineralizing cells. Demineralizing cells. Osteoclast cells also called bone remodeling cells. Bone remodeling cells. These are the phagocytic cells of the bone. Osteoclasts are phagocytic cells of the bone. Bone phagocytic cells are called osteoclast. Next, osteocyte. Osteocyte are inactive cells. Osteocytes are inactive cells. These are mature cells. These are mature cells. Osteocyte converted into osteoblast converted into osteocyte cells. Osteoblast is immature cells. Osteocyte is mature cells. Mature cells. Next, types of bones. Based on the formation of bones, these are four types. Cartilaginous bones, investing bone, sesamoid bone, visceral bone. First, cartilage bone. Cartilage bone are replacing bone or endochondral bones. Cartilage bone or endochondral bone are replacing bone. These bones are formed by ossification within cartilage. Ossification within cartilage. Ossification means accumulation of minerals in the cartilage. So these are called replacing bones because cartilage is replaced by bone. These are present in the cartilage bones are present in the limbs, girdles, pectoral girdle or pelvic girdle and the vertebrae. These are formed in embryonic stage by cartilage, but these are ossified to form bone in adults. Next, investing bone are membranous bones. Investing bone are membranous bones. Ossification, these are formed by the ossification in the embryonic mesenchyme. Ossification in the embryonic mesenchyme. Examples of investing bones, most of the cranial bones, these are cranial bones, most of the cranial bones are membranous bones. Most of the cranial bones are membranous bones. Next, sesamoid bone. Sesamoid bones are formed by the ossification within tendons. Ossification within tendons. These are present in the patella. Patella or kneecap. Patella or kneecap. Pisiform bone of wrist of mammals. Pisiform bones, wrist bones. Wrist bone are called pisiform bone, single bone. Pisiform bone is a sesamoid bone. Pisiform bone is formed by the ossification within the tendon. It forms pisiform bone. Next, visceral bones. Visceral bones. These are formed by the ossification within the soft tissues. Ossification in the soft tissues forms visceral bones. These are soft tissues or visceral organs, visceral tissues. Ossification in the soft tissue forms visceral bones. These are oscardis and ospinis. Oscardis means heart. Inside the heart of ruminants, visceral bones are formed inside the heart of ruminants. Ruminants, examples of ruminants are cow, goat, sheep, etc. Next, ospinis. The glands penis of rodents, bats and carnivores has ossified bone. Ossified bone, these are visceral bones. Os penis present in the rodents, bats and the carnivores. Rodents, examples of rodents are rat, guinea pig, squirrels. These are rodents. Inside the glands penis, ossification inside the glands penis is called os penis. Glands penis means front of the penis is called, anterior part of the penis is called glands penis. Next, based on the structure of bone, these are two types, spongy bone and a compact bone. Spongy bone. This is epiphysis. It is metaphysis. Epiphysis. This region is epiphysis. This region is metaphysis. It is diaphysis. This region is diaphysis. Epiphysis, metaphysis. This is diaphysis. Spongy bone looks like spongy. It is present in the epiphysis and metaphysis region. The columns of bone is called trabeculae. Trabeculae is irregular in shape. The space between the trabeculae is filled with red bone marrow. The diaphysis of long bone is made up of compact bone. Next, structure of compact bone. Diaphysis is a compact bone. It is present between the epiphysis. Next, metaphysis. Metaphysis present between the epiphysis and diaphysis. Metaphysis is a growth zone because it has epiphyseal plate. Metaphysis contains epiphyseal plate. Epiphyseal plate helps for the elongation of bone. In adult, this epiphyseal plate converted into bone. It is epiphyseal line. Next, diaphysis. Diaphysis is covered by outer dense connective tissue called periosteum. Long bones of diaphysis has a central cavity called marrow cavity. Marrow cavity filled with bone marrow. Marrow cavity is surrounded by endosteum. Marrow cavity is surrounded by endosteum. between the periosteum and endosteum, between the periosteum and endosteum, bone matrix is present. Bone matrix is present. This matrix is formed by layers. This matrix is formed by layers. Outer circumferential lamellae present beneath the periosteum. This is periosteum. This is outer circumferential lamellae. Matrix arranged as lamellae. Outer circumferential lamellae beneath the periosteum. And inner circumferential lamellae. This is inner circumferential lamellae. Inner circumferential lamellae around the endosteum. Inner circumferential lamellae around the endosteum. Between the outer circumferential lamellae and inner circumferential lamellae, between the outer circumferential lamellae and inner circumferential lamellae, many Haversian systems are present. Many Haversian systems are present in between the outer circumferential lamellae and inner circumferential lamellae. In between the Haversian systems, the tissue is called interstitial lamellae. In between the Haversian systems, the interstitial lamellae is present. Haversian system is the structural unit of bone is called Haversian system. This is Haversian system. Haversian system consists of Haversian system consists of Haversian canal. This is Haversian canal. Haversian system consists of Haversian canal. Haversian canal runs parallel to the bone marrow. Haversian canal runs parallel to the bone marrow. These are the Haversian canals. Haversian canals runs parallel to the bone marrow. Each Haversian canal contains artery, vein, lymph vessels. Each Haversian canal contains artery, vein, lymph vessels. Haversian canal is surrounded by concentric lamellae. Lamellae means layers. Layers. It has lacunae. Fluid filled space is called lacunae. Fluid filled space is called lacunae. Each lacunae consists of one osteocyte. Lacunae contains osteocyte. Osteoblast is modified into osteocytes. Osteocytes are inactive cells. Lacunae is a fluid filled space that encloses a osteocyte. Each lacunae forms a thread-like structures. Each lacunae forms a thread-like structures. These are called canalicula. Each lacunae forms thread-like structures called canalicula. The osteocyte साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट्स, साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट्स, दिस इज ऑस्टियोसाइट, साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट, दिस इज साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस, दिस इज ऑस्टियोसाइट, साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट्स कम्स थ्रू द कैनालिकुले, कम्स थ्रू द, दिस इज कैनालिकुले, दिस इज साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट, साइटोप्लाज्मिक प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑस्टियोसाइट्स, कैनालिकुले कनेक्ट्स one osteocyte to another osteocyte, these are canalicule, canalicule connects one lacunae with another and connects with haversian system, canalicule connects one lacunae with another lacunae and connects with lacunae with haversian canals, connects with haversian canals, Haversian canals, Haversian canal, lamellae, lacunae, these three are collectively called Haversian system, Haversian system, Haversian canal, lamellae, lacunae, these three are collectively called Haversian system or ostium, ostium, these are the structural units of, these are the units of bone. Next, Haversian canals are connected by transverse or oblique canals, called Volkmann canals. These canals connects periosteum with Haversian canal or Haversian canal with bone marrow. The nutrients or gases exchanged through the blood vessels present in the Haversian canal. The dry weight of fully growth bone. Contains 65% of inorganic substance, and 35% of organic substance. The main inorganic substance is calcium phosphate. This calcium phosphate present in the form of crystals of hydroxyapatite. During aging, the main organic substance is collagen fibers. During aging, the bone accumulates inorganic substance that causes brittleness of bones. When bone is broken, the osteocyte cells are activated into osteoblast cells. These osteoblast cells produce minerals and it joins the bone. When bone is kept in the dilute HCl, when bone is kept in the dilute HCl, it makes soft the bone, because the inorganic substances are dissolved in the HCl, so the bone is soft.